Eternal Eclipse, Void Knight. Do some gameplay here and some bossing at the end.
I see. Take care.
This build's a little different in that you don't really spam attacks like you do with a lot of other melee builds. You sort of gather up the monsters in a group and use Void Cleave or Racing Strike if there's enough of them. It's not heavily on Echo. It's got the default amount of Echo. Just because the way the sword works, it won't get the bonus on the Echo because it'll be in cooldown. Not a lot of reason to Echo.
Yeah. Stand down or die. Stand down or die. Two shots.
Overall, the DPS is probably the same as any other melee build. It's just that it does it in small shots and lets you be mobile in between the shots so that you don't take as much damage. That's really the main benefit of the build. Not about spamming tons of shots that do a lot of damage. It's about occasionally spamming a shot that does a lot of damage.
Stand down or die.
All right, now to the boss. The Dreadnought's wreckage. This one's actually kind of easy. Just don't fight in the middle.
You. I remember you, mortal.
Yeah.
There you are.
Accept it, mortal. Heck. The void is all that is left. Let the void take you.
I don't think that's gonna happen. We'll see though. Could mess up. I already almost messed up once.
The abyss calls to us. Can't you hear it? Drown in darkness.
Stand down or die.
Gods, emperors, it was all for nothing. Accept it, mortal. The void is all that is left. Let the void take you. The abyss calls to us. Can't you hear it?
So you can see I'm just constantly moving, I'm not really standing in one spot for very long.
Different. Am I finally free?
And that's pretty much how the thing works. Ooh, nice.